Fashion and literary representation have always been intertwined. The theatricality of dress and fashioning one's day-to-day self is similar to taking on a literary persona. Welcome, everyone, to our fifth annual Gallatin Fashion Show, Narrative Threads.
I'm excited. It's always been an amazing experience to work with the Gallatin Fashion Show.
I heard about the show actually before I had even applied, and it was kind of one of the main reasons that I wanted to be in this school.
So this is my first time sewing, so it's definitely a learning experience for me.
This is the first time I've ever touched a sewing machine. Like, when I first started, I just was like, yes, I know everything. And then I got into it and I was like, I have no freaking idea of what I'm doing.
The show is so well run, from the look that shoot, the models, everything is so professional. I just love participating every year. I based my collection off of the book The Lorax. In the book, it's very colorful at first, and once the onesler comes in and starts his business, everything gets like darker blue, darker purple. So I had my collection go from bright colors to darker, and then my final piece kind of has that seed in it where it's bright sequins. There's hope for the future. This is my first time as a designer, but the past 2 years I have been the hair girl. It's interesting to take somebody else's vision and to try to turn it into something. My collection did not turn out what I had originally drawn it to be, but I think, you know, it ended up taking really interesting directions that I was really happy about.
With the trend of digital age, what's going to happen with all of the extra books? So myself and Maddie Levine are designing a collection out of book pages. It's been so much fun.
My jewelry is based on the story of Lita and the Swan. It has a lot of pearls because of the white of the swan.
I'm a visual artist and paint. This is my first time collaborating with a fashion designer.
She gave me my free space to be creative. It was seamless.
I have two collections. One is on Dance Macabre, that is about celebration of death, kind of going on to this other adventure after life. My second collection is on Anderson's Nightingale. It's a debate between a real, talented, passionate person versus a superficial, glamorous, all dolled up version of something. Kind of the idea of we can't really define beauty.
Lavinia Roberts is a contemporary New York City based playwright who wrote an Emily Dickinson inspired play called Nobodies. And from my collection, from the play, from the poem, is this underlining narrative of what it means to really embrace obscurity, of embrace being a nobody, and really celebrating that.
The first thing that came to my mind was Where the Wild Things Are. I just like found something very magical in that and thought that it would portray really well through clothing. Just started sewing, which was definitely kind of scary, I guess, because I didn't know if I would be able to finish it or even if it would look good, but piece by piece it definitely came together.
Microphone 4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
You go left first and you stop there.
The process of creating the collection was almost like a workshop within itself.
At the end, I know that I'm going to be happy and I'm giving it my all.
This year with literature and fashion, what I do with makeup is express it, use it as a storytelling device.
I mean, 1 second I'm wearing body paint and all of a sudden I'm in natural makeup. It's fun.
And I wait for the show and I watch and I enjoy it and just take it all in.
I just need to make sure my mom is there.
I'm just really excited about it.
Very excited. I've been planning since last year. I can't wait.
When we get dressed, when we think about what to wear, we're always telling ourselves a story. We're imagining ourselves against some kind of backdrop, unfolding a narrative, and it's about literary emulation.
In our creative process, we aspire to make the unconventional conventional by turning old book pages into garments. We honestly hope to inspire others to push the boundaries beyond normality and produce the unexpected.
If you want, we'll help tonight. My collection is called Odyssey in Fashion, and it's based upon Homer's epic poem, The Odyssey. I'm so happy with the way my collection turned out, and I hope you guys enjoy it.
Our collection was inspired by the absurdist writing of Albert Camus. The looks in our collection portray the struggle between the internal and external identities.
My collection, Femme Fatale, follows the transition of Lolita's character throughout the novel. This sweetness is shown by the flowers in the collection.
White teeth teens are up for it. I know you love it when the hair can start to draw. I like your record.
My collection is called Here at 3 a.m., taking inspiration from the American poet Charles Bukowski, and more specifically, the interactions or lack thereof between individuals.
We're very excited to show you our video titled The Philosopher in A Minor.
In the video, you're going to see a lot of the sculptural accessories that we created.
I based the pieces in my collection off of three books: Joan Didion's The White Album, Patti Smith's Just Kids, and J.D. Salinger's Freddie and Zoe. The characters in these books really inspire me because of how comfortable they are with uncertainty.
This is my collection, Me and T, inspired by The Giving Tree and dedicated to my mom. Hi, Mommy.
Concentration takes forever to explain, so I'll spare you that. But one thing I'm not studying is fashion. I'm actually coming at this from a history of storytelling and costuming. I chose the myth of Orpheus because I'm fascinated by how the clothing we wear changes the stories that we tell about ourselves.
For my collection, I drew from existential literature. I found inspiration in the works of Friedrich Nietzsche and Ambrose Bierce. The collection is meant to provoke the simultaneous dread and excitement of existential philosophy.
White teeth teens are up for it. I know you love it when the hairpins start to draw.
Stories shape us. The books we read develop our psyche, provide escape, and make us feel understood. These designs are inspired by my favorite books. So, welcome to my library. Welcome to the library.
Beautiful. I feel great. I think it went really well.
It was very exciting.
Yeah, it was amazing. It was a great show. Everyone did so well.
I learned a ton. I feel great.
Yeah. This has been such a learning experience. We've done it.
Everyone was smiling. I'm happy that my work made everyone else happy.
Oh, I thought this was an awesome show. A bunch of people who never designed. Who designed? And I thought I saw some careers out there.
To